to Through the Bible. We are in our last story from the book of Genesis in the Bible. Joseph reunited with his family. Genesis chapters 43 to 50. When the food brought from Egypt had nearly all been used, Jacob said one day to his sons, "Go again to Egypt and buy us more food." But Judah said to him, "Father, the man who sold us the food said he would have nothing more to do with us unless we brought our youngest brother with us. If you would let Benjamin go with us, then we will go to Egypt for food. Otherwise, we cannot." To make sure that his beloved Benjamin came back and that the Egyptian ruler remained friendly, Jacob sent back the money his sons had found in their wheat sacks and also some gifts for the man, honey and almonds and other nuts and spices. Once more, the little party came to the place in Egypt where food was sold. Joseph saw them arrive, but he did not pay attention to them. Instead, he sent his steward, the man in charge of his home, to them to take them there and to get ready a great feast so that Joseph could entertain them at noon. When the steward led them away, they were all very much afraid. They thought that Joseph would make them all his slaves. In their fear, they tried to tell the steward all about the money, but he only smiled and told them not to be afraid. The truth was that their God was blessing them. What a surprise they must have had when he told them that he had himself put their money into their wheat sacks. Into Joseph's great house he led them and gave them water to wash their tired and dirty feet. He even saw to it that their donkeys were given food. After that, they had quietly to wait until Joseph came back. You can imagine how nervous they were. What could possibly be happening? When Joseph came home, they all bowed low before him, exactly as the dreams long ago had foretold. And then they handed him the presents they had brought. Joseph was very friendly, but he said not a word about being their brother. All he did was to ask how they were and how their father was. When he looked across at his own brother Benjamin and asked if this was the youngest brother they had told him about, for Benjamin he prayed saying, "God be gracious unto you, my son." But then his feelings overcame him. Quickly he went to his own room and wept. Then he washed his face and went back to his visitors and gave orders that the feast should begin. Since the Egyptians would not allow the Hebrews to eat with them, the guests celebrated the feast in two groups. The brothers were surprised by one thing though. They were arranged at the meal according to their ages, but they could not understand how the Egyptians knew in order which were older and which younger. Something strange happened too. Joseph sent to Benjamin 5 times as much of the food as to any of the others. When the meal was over, Joseph called his steward and told him to fill their sacks with wheat, and just as he had done the last time, secretly to put their money back in the bags. This time though, he had also put in the bag of the youngest his own silver cup. The next morning, as soon as it was light, the brothers set off on their way home. They were not far from the city when Joseph sent a steward after them. When he caught up with them, he asked them how, after all the kindness that had been shown to them, they could be so ungrateful as to have stolen Joseph's cup. Of course, they denied having stolen anything. They didn't know what was in their bags. They were so sure that they hadn't done any wrong, they even said that if anyone had stolen the cup, he should die for his crime. And they would willingly become the slaves of the Egyptian ruler. And then the cup was found. Oh, how terribly upset they were. In their sorrow, they tore their clothes. Sadly, the little group went back to the steward to face the anger of Joseph. When they reached his home, they threw themselves down the ground in front of him. But Joseph pretended to be terribly angry. They were so upset, they promised all to become his slaves. But Joseph told them to go home to their father, except the one in whose bag the cup had been found. And that one was Benjamin, the favorite of their old father Jacob. Without him, they would not dare go home. It would break the old man's heart. So they pleaded with Joseph, and Judah begged to be allowed to stay as a slave in Benjamin's place. Then Joseph could not stand it any longer. He sent all the Egyptians out of the room, and when they had gone, he told his brothers who he was. While he did so, he wept so loudly that the Egyptians in the rest of the house could hear how upset he was. The brothers were terribly afraid. They remembered what they had done to Joseph. But he comforted them and said, "Come close to me. Don't be afraid because of what you did long ago. God wanted me to be here, and it is because he helped me and showed me what to do that there is food in Egypt, and that you did not die of starvation. I came here as a slave, but God has made me a great man in the land. God told me that there would be 7 years of famine. 2 years have passed, but there are still 5 years to come. I have still a great deal of work to do. Because there is famine back in our own land too, you must go back home and fetch our father Jacob and all your families and your flocks and herds. Come to the land of Goshen, the province on the eastern side of Egypt. I shall see to it that Pharaoh gives you a place to stay. There you can live in peace, and I will see to it that you will always have enough to eat." Then he hugged and kissed all his brothers, but especially Benjamin, the youngest. Now when the news of all this was brought to Pharaoh, Pharaoh was overjoyed, and so were all the nobles in his court. Pharaoh even sent a special message to the brothers. They must take with them all the food they needed and quickly come back to Egypt with their father and their families and all their animals. They must not worry about the future. All the riches of Egypt would be theirs. How thrilled the brothers must have been to hear that promise. When they turned back homeward, they were loaded with gifts, and they did not have to carry the new clothes and the silver Joseph had given them on the backs of their donkeys either. For Benjamin, there were special gifts, 5 new suits and 300 pieces of silver. And for their father, 10 donkeys loaded with rich gifts and food of all kinds. By order of Pharaoh, the brothers were given wagons to carry back all their goods. Joseph said a strange thing to those brothers just before they left. See that you don't quarrel with one another on the way." He knew what they were like, you see. When they came to Egypt, they had been afraid. What had Pharaoh's officer done to Simeon while they were away? What would he do to them now? But how different it was when they went back home. Gladness made them hurry so that they could tell their father the wonderful news as quickly as possible. And when they told him, he would not believe them. With gladness, Joseph's brothers went back to their father in Canaan to tell him the wonderful news about their lost brother. They told him all about Joseph and of the invitation to go and live in Goshen. Jacob told them to prepare for the journey. So all the people and their hundreds of animals began the long trail down into Egypt. Yet when they reached Beersheba, where Abraham and Isaac had stopped over once long before, they stopped over too for a very important reason. Jacob had not forgotten that he owed God the deepest thankfulness for giving him back Joseph once more. At Beersheba, he built an altar of stones, and at a very solemn service, an offering of thanksgiving was made to God. During that night, after the great service, God came to Jacob in a dream and spoke to him. "Jacob, I am the God of your father. Don't be afraid of going down into Egypt, because I shall be with you, and you will see your son Joseph. There I will make of you a great nation, and when the right time comes, I shall bring that nation out of Egypt once more." When they arrived in Egypt, Jacob and his family were 66 altogether. As soon as the news reached him of their approach, Joseph went out in his splendid chariot to meet them. And when he met his father, Jacob, they threw their arms around one another and cried, "How wonderful to be together when they had not expected to see one another ever again." Joseph then took his father and five of his brothers to meet Pharaoh, and Pharaoh gave them permission to move into the land of Goshen, the very fertile part of the east of the Nile, where that great river flows down to the sea. There they lived happily, and Joseph saw to it that however bad the famine became, they always had enough food. When Jacob was 147 years old, he felt that the time of his death was coming near. When Joseph heard this, he took his two sons, Ephraim and Manasseh, and went to see the old father so that he might bless them. Jacob blessed all his own sons and Joseph's two sons as well. Joseph was surprised to hear Jacob giving a greater blessing to his younger son Ephraim than to the older Manasseh. Manasseh would become a great man and the father of a great tribe, but the greatness of Ephraim and his family would be much more. In time, it happened just as Jacob had said. Soon afterward, Jacob died, and as they had promised him, they did not bury him in Egypt, but went all the way to Canaan to bury him with Abraham and Isaac in the cave of Machpelah. Now, when Jacob died, Joseph's brothers were worried. So once more they sent messengers to him to beg his forgiveness. But Joseph reminded them of what he had said to them before. "I am not God. True enough, you meant to do me harm, but God meant it for good, as it has turned out." Joseph died at the age of 110 years. Before he died, he had a last important message for them. God would still take them out of Egypt and return them to the land he had promised to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. When they left Egypt to go to Canaan, they must take his body with them.